So pretty early on when I got to South Sudan, we had a really difficult case, and I think this was my hardest experience there. It was actually my first day, and the OB that I was taking over from was still there. And she, I was getting oriented or whatever, and she called me over to the OR and said, "I'm doing a vacuum. You should come and see how it goes." And I ended up participating because it was so difficult. And the situation was an 18-year-old girl who was having her first baby and had come in, excuse me, with a stillbirth after laboring for 4 days at home. And she was already septic. Blood pressure was low. Pulse was really high. And she was getting antibiotics and actually pressors in the OR. And they did a vacuum to get the baby out. And it was really tough. And I actually ended up scrubbing in with the other OB. And we really needed the force of two of us to get that baby out, but we didn't want to have to open her abdomen because that would just make her so much sicker. But we got it out. It actually went okay. And you know, we examined her afterward and tried to see if anything was necrotic, but it looked okay. And then we sent her to the ward. In the beginning, she was doing okay. She was weak and, you know, infected, but talking, and her parents were there taking care of her. And then, but still very infected. And over the course of the next day, her blood pressure started dropping. And we knew this was probably from sepsis, and we made her antibiotics more aggressive. And briefly, the anesthesiologist thought it would be a good idea to put her on pressors because her blood pressure was so low. And we talked that over after a few hours, and the hospital supervisor really weighed in, I think very importantly here, and said, you know, we can't put everyone on pressors. We can't run an ICU. We don't have that capability. And if she isn't better, you know, isn't supporting her blood pressure after 24 hours, she really needs to do it on her own because we can't support this for long. And she was right. And so we stopped the pressors, and she just continued to be very infected. And over the next 2 days, she really decompensated. I don't think the pressors would have saved her. I think she was just too sick. But it was really, really hard to watch her die. She just became unconscious, and then I think we had to put an NG tube, and her parents just kind of stayed, like, literally sitting in her bed. And by the end, her breathing was so labored, and it was painful. Like, it looked very painful, even though she was unconscious. And I wanted to do something to help her, and I could have here. You know, I could have intubated her, I could have sedated her, but you can't. You can't do anything there, so you just have to watch her die. And her parents at the end were sitting on her bed, each one holding a hand, and just watching her. And when I knew she was going to die, I told them that, and I said, it's really, really likely she's going to die. And we had a translator explain to her, to the parents, that, and they were accepting. They understood at that point, and they said, you know, it's in God's hands. But to me, that was tough. An 18-year-old shouldn't be dying having a baby. So that was hard. And I think, you know, you rethink what could I have done differently. And I don't know. I know that she would have lived if she'd given birth in New York. But I don't know that in that setting that we could have done anything differently. It's tough. I think maternal mortality really boils my blood because it's entirely preventable, or almost entirely preventable. And that's a perfect example. You know, she's a young, healthy woman, and if she'd come in after 1 day of labor instead of four, she would be alive. I don't know that you ever make it go away. The hospital supervisor actually said something I think that's really true. She said, every doctor has their own personal graveyard in their mind, and it's true. Like, you hold them with you forever, and you think about them, and nobody else knows it's there, but you carry it.